Hey everyone, I'm Hannah from the Earth Lover Love and I'm a nature enthusiast. In my channel, I share the simple ways in our daily life to enjoy and embrace the earth, the beautiful nature, and to learn about the sustainability. If you want to know more about this topic or just simply love the earth and nature, don't forget to subscribe.
Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Earth Lover Lab, the show where every day's a new adventure. Today we're going to be going on a quest to find wild edible mushrooms. Oh yeah! Fall is the season of appetite. You heard right, we decided to go mushroom hunting in the woods. We went exploring Joliet, Illinois, a city in the northern part of the state of Illinois. No licenses are required here in Illinois for mushroom hunting. Just make sure that you're not hunting in a designated nature preserve area. Remember, don't use this as a replacement for your field guide. Mushrooms can be very dangerous, so make sure to do thorough research before you pick any mushrooms. Alright, so this time our target was the hen of the woods, or maitake as it's known in Japanese. This mushroom is famous for its crispy texture and delicious aroma.
Alright, what do we have? We found something. Uh-oh.
Lean in there.
Uh-oh.
There's a cluster of...
There we go! Puff gold. This is definitely puff gold.
Wow, what have we found here? It appears to be Apioperidon, also known as the pear-shaped puffball.
Oh my god, there's so many over there. There, let me.
It's all smooth on the whole thing.
Yeah.
Bottom, if I didn't rip it, it would be smooth all the way to the bottom. When you rip it in half, it's kind of like memory foam or like one of those magic erasers, like real fluffy.
Yeah, there's no...
All white on the inside.
Gills, yeah.
If you saw like the shape of a mushroom on the inside...
Yeah, that's not possible.
Don't want that. Yeah. Or if it's any other color than pure white like this, you don't want to eat it.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah.
Cool, good deal. Yeah.
Hair-shaped puffballs.
Awesome! Okay, so these are puff balls, but it looks like this is already dead. It's not really dead, but it's done. And the reason why it's called puff ball is in the pocket.
There we have it, the hen of the woods. Hen of the woods is typically found on oak tree stumps or at the base of dead and dying trees. When identifying the hen of the woods, take a look underneath the caps. You'll find that it does not have gills, but instead it has pores.
It's huge.
Here, squat down next to it.
All right. Let's harvest this.
Try to harvest.
Chicken will be orange.
Chicken will be orange. This one's the end of the woods.
Maitake.
Two different things.
This is maitake, yeah.
Yeah, so I'm hoping that it just snaps right off. If not, I might try to use my ID to like cut it out of there. Yeah, I think I could just...
And they're supposed to come back every year. Oh, goodness gracious, a lot of isopods. Yeah.
Wow,
Yeah,
this thing is heavy.
Oh, I bet.
Wow.
Hopefully they will come back next year. Oh, I see the mycelium here.
Yeah. Didn't it say that year after year this will come back?
Yeah, they'll come back.
At my house, I got a brush that we could brush it off with better.
Yeah.
So. Yeah, we'll just
put
it in the bag.
Huge.
Huge.
Oh my gosh. Oh my God.
All right, so here we are back in the kitchen with the maitake mushroom. Today we're gonna be making maitake pizza toast. We're gonna start out by cleaning everything up really well. Get all the dirt and bugs out of there. Then when we're finished cleaning it up, we're gonna take our paper tissues and we're gonna make sure to get these dabbed real nice and dry because we're gonna want to crisp these up in a bit. Make sure when you're seasoning your mushrooms not to go too crazy because these are gonna absorb a lot of flavor. If you're using soy sauce or anything like that, these act like a sponge, so don't put too much. Now that we've got everything seasoned evenly, we're gonna wrap it in aluminum foil, add a couple dabs of butter for flavor. Now the only thing left to do is pop it in the oven and let it bake at 420 degrees. We left it about 20 to 25 minutes. Now we're putting a little bit of ketchup on our toast that we've already prepared. You could use pizza sauce, but we're using ketchup. A little bit of garlic paste and some seasonings to make our sauce. Then we're gonna start sprinkling some cheese on there. Oh yeah. Now that we've sprinkled it with our cheese, let's reach for that bacon.
Bacon crumbles.
Now let's take some of our cooked mushrooms and slap it on top of our pizza toast. One more sprinkle of cheese and let's throw it in the oven and broil it and get that cheese nice and browned.
There we have it, the Hen of the Woods pizza toast. All right, everybody, thanks so much for joining us on this adventure today. We can't wait to see you back again here at the Earth Lover Lab. If you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Hope you have a wonderful day.